Okay, so welcome to this closing ceremony. All the sessions are now over, so we can start. I will chair this session as the president of Metamorphos, which is the international association owning this Congress, this Metamaterials Congress. So first of all, I would like to give you some figures about this edition. We had 328 participants from 36 countries, and this is the usual diagram we show any closing ceremony. So you can see how these participants are split among the different countries. Then, of course, as usual, I'll show you some pictures taken during the conference, so to see how effective was the discussion had here, and what we bring home, for instance, from the welcome reception, very nice place, very good food, and from the excursion to the national park, going into the tent and cooking by ourselves some meat. Then this 50th anniversary of event since Veselago paper and the social gala dinner with the exhibition perfectly organized of the original samples of we have read and found in the papers. So this was really an exceptional event. Now I would like to give the floor to Carsten Roxel, who chairs the Student Paper Competition Committee and the Award Committee, for announcing the winners.
Yeah, okay, thanks Filiberto for the introduction. Yeah, so welcome also from my side, so from this closing ceremony here. Yeah, so I would like to put up front that I have been enjoying very much this honor and also this responsibility to act here as the head of this student paper competition and award committee. I found it extremely exciting because actually I went to this conference in a kind of different way as I went usually to the conferences. Yeah, so on purpose I really have been skipping most of the invited talks. And went on purpose to the contributor talks to see as much as possible from those contributions here. And this was a kind of funny thing because it was a bit on individual bites, yeah, of many different subjects revolving all around these aspects of metamaterials and being exposed to these kind of things. I found it is very rewarding and I found it quite exciting actually to act here in that position and to support the community with this. Of course, this is not a decision here of individual persons. Yeah, there have been multiple persons actually involved in that selection process. And I would like to thank particularly my three colleagues that have been involved here and acting also with me together in this student paper competition and award committee. So two of them are here. One of them unfortunately had to leave already. But I would just like to thank also Jensen Lee, Owen Miller and Roman Fleury for the support and for the interaction also we had all the time at the conference here and discussing also among each other the different contributions. So the primary task actually of the committee was to select also upfront, before the conference, the different contributions and submissions we had to the student paper competition. If I remember correctly, so we had around 20 explicit submissions of students that wanted to be considered in that sort of competition. And we had to select out of those submissions only a few of them, yeah, which we can take into account here. And those are shown here on this slide. Not sure if this works. Yeah. So unfortunately, there was one person that could not attend and who had to cancel the contribution on last minute. Due to visa issue, yeah, which is something that happens unfortunately, and yeah, we have to live with this. So out of these four participants here, they all give oral contributions actually on their papers. And there was also a special site at the poster session where they could present their work and where we committee members also largely interacted with them to identify actually the best student contributions out of these four. As you can easily imagine, so this is not that easy. Yeah? So eventually we were not able to decide actually on a single winner, but jointly we discussed this and we've been deciding on two different persons that are going to be awarded. And the second place is usually best to start with first. I have to thank also the different sponsors that made actually these prizes available. And we try to introduce also the sponsors first because we actually announced the winner just to appreciate also their support to the community. So the second prize of the student choir competition had been supported from RSC, the Royal Society of Chemistry. And the second place is worth a £200 book voucher and a 1-year subscription to RSC. One hard copy of the last book by Sergei Trofiakov, but I think this is a bit of a wrong statement here, so this was not intentionally there. So there is the combination actually of two prizes, am I correct here? Yeah. So there was a kind of special prize also that we have been considering for the best contribution on diffraction theory among the contributions here from the student paper competition. And the person that got the second prize also had the best contribution in the context of the diffraction theory. And then I'm happy, so a little bit of tension here. Yeah, so I'm happy to announce that you're in second place, and I hope there is no mispronunciation in the name, but it's Hafsa Alati. Can you come here? So, it's not just a warm handshake, yeah, but it's also something real we can hand over here, at least in terms of paper, certificate, and indication on how to get the money, actually. Yeah? So, congratulations, I think, from all of us. Yeah.
So, we made some jokes on what this prize actually means. Is it like a enjoy the reading, or you should read it, or what? And then, just one correction, it's not my own personal book contribution, it's written together with Andrei Osipov, who is actually doing most of the work. But it's about scattering theory. Thank you.
So, then we can have an oral examination in the next year's conference. Yeah? Okay, so this was the second prize. Of course, there's also a winner. Yeah, and again, we decided to raise a bit the tension. So the first prize has been supported here from CRC, the Taylor and Francis Group, and this is worth a £300 book voucher and 1 year online subscription to CRC Press. Yeah, and so this is worth to say, there's always been a hard decision. So there have been a few or all contributions have been good, but we had to decide eventually on one contribution that gets the first place, and the prize goes here to Philippe Den Ulnie for its contribution on good Wi-Fi waves bouncing around inside an indoor room to perform analog computing. Congratulations, yeah, from all of us. Very good. As it was also said from Filiberto, so this was not just a poster or a student competition which we were asked to chair, but also a general, acting as a kind of general award committee. Yeah. So we are very fortunate actually to have support also here from different further partners to support us that have been denoting different prizes. And they are from now on linked to a particular category. Yeah. We are going to assign them here winners to these different type of categories. So we will start with prizes that have been handed or supported by us from the American Physical Society. On these four different categories, on best theoretical paper, best applied paper, best experimental paper, and the best poster award. And I'm very happy actually that we have quite a few persons actually from APS with us that also supported us in the selection of the candidates, yeah, which of the awardees, which are going to get this. I would be very happy if also the colleagues from APS join me here on stage to maybe to say thanks also from their side. And to help me also in the awarding actually of the committees.
Hello, I'm Julie Kim Sions. I'm the managing editor of Physical Review Applied, and I guess this is a good chance for me to once again thank everybody for Filiberto, Andrea, Vincenzo, Carsten. I don't know how you did that job. We, in the week that we've been here, we've heard a lot of great invited and contributing talks, and it was a very difficult decision, I'm sure. And so thank you very much, and thank you for welcoming us and making us part of this community. We're very, very happy to be here.
I think Filiberto will later say also some more words of appreciation to you towards the support of the community, but also I want to express this from my side. So this is very good to have you here also on board and to be involved directly in the sort of activities that this community drives forward. I think this is very good. Yeah. Let's start this here. So with the best APS poster award. So we have been looking around, and obviously this is a tough decision, but the best APS poster award was then given to storage and retrieval of electromagnetic waves with metamaterial analog of electromagnetically induced transparency from Toshihiro Nakanishi and Masao. So the second prize that we were asked to identify was for the best theoretical paper. Yeah. So I guess that this is not much surprise, but this was probably the hardest decision because there are so many good theoretical contributions here also at this conference. Eventually we have been assigning this to retrieving regular photonic structures through global optimization from a number of colleagues here from France, Switzerland, and the States. Goes then for the best APS experimental paper, and the winner in that category is non-reciprocity in mechanical metamaterials from Corentin Coulet. Is he or an ambassador from his group here? Okay, if not, I think we will transmit this message via email, yeah, and you will happily receive then the voucher and the certificate by some sort of other means in the near future. The last award to be given in that sort of category here is the best APS award for best applied paper. And the winner here is colleagues from Alto with the title Metallic Nanoparticle Array Lasers with Ultra-Fast Modulation Speeds in Highly Directional Beam. There's somebody here. That was, they have the shortest way home, so it's likely for them to sneak out. but I think so that for them it's probably most easiest there to get the award and the prize, because we can just leave it on their desk here probably when going home. Okay, so let's take this occasion. Just, is somebody having a camera? So let's just take once a picture with those people that are present here and could get these awards, and with our colleagues from APS. Thank you very much. Congratulations to the winner. Thank you very much for the awards. Okay, then this sort of duty is nearly over. So there's just one contribution left, or one prize left that we were asked to entitle to somebody. So this is a special prize sponsored from MDPI. That was the only restriction, that this is the best prize for particular for contribution on photonics. The award consists of 800 francs here a respective certificate. Yeah. So I'm happy to announce also here the winner. The winner is Inigo Liberal, yeah, and co-authors from Spain and from the States with the paper Controlling Photon Statistics with Areas of Quantum Emitters. Congratulations. This part of my job. I would like to hand over then again to Caliberto, who wants to say some more words of appreciation towards our sponsors.
Okay, thank you so much, Carsten, for having shared this comedy and announced the awards. Now I will start with the thanks. And first of all, I would like to thank our diamond sponsors and American Physical Society, so you know already what they have done for us, these awards. We had also the special session, so we have established in the years a very fruitful collaboration and that we hope to continue in the future editions of this Congress. Then I would like to thank also the other diamond sponsors, Metamaterial Technologies. Actually, Georges and Temos are not here, I think, but so they have supported us in different editions of our Congress. Then I would like to thank also our exhibitors, so you can recognize here also the faces. I would like to thank all our sponsors for having supported this edition of the Congress. With many of them, we have already a continuous collaboration during the years. Now, please join me now thanking the people who made really this edition of the Congress possible and so successful. So first of all, I would like to thank Vincenzo Galdi for having shared the technical program committee and put together this fantastic high-level scientific program. I would like to thank Alessio Monti, who is the chairman of the steering committee. He did a very hard everyday work. He was really behind any of the different committees, the program committee, the steering committee, the organizer. He was the initiator of all the actions there. So thanks, Alessio, for your hard work. Then I would like to thank Davide Ramaccia, you all know him. He did a fantastic job in organizing the sponsors and the exhibitors package and to select these sponsors, exhibitors, and put them in contact with the local organizers. Then I would like to thank Mirko Barbuto, he is not here, but
He did a fantastic work, also a hard work, behind Vincenzo in for the organizing aspects of the program committee, and was the editor of the conference proceedings book you can download as a registered person to this Congress from the website. Last but not least, here I would like to thank Enrico Acciardi. You all have been in touch with him. He's the financial manager of Metamorphos, and he is also doing a hard everyday work on registration and budget and financial aspects. But of course, the last and biggest thanks go to the local organizers. And so I would like to ask Sergei to come here and to.
I need to say only two words, actually, that Filiberto, you made a mistake. You should have invited everyone, and that's what I'm actually doing. So please, all the helpers and the assistants and everyone, with these beautiful color things and results, just come on. Thank you very much. Every day, you can take a photo with a great camera. Thank you for your help, and thank you all for coming there. Thank you.
Once again, many thanks to you all for this fantastic and memorable edition of the Metamaterials Congress. Now, just a few words about Metamorphos, which is the International Scientific Association on Metamaterials. It was born in 2007. Sergei Tretiakov was the father of this, then he was the president for the two terms allowed by our articles, and then I was elected as the successor of Sergei, so now I'm the pro tempore president of this. I'm very proud to be the pro tempore president of this association. As you can see here, we have a mission which is not only related to training programs, which is very important to organization of scientific events about metamaterials, but also this association was intended to integrate, create, manage, coordinate research projects in the field of metamaterials. And now, thanks also to Stefano Maci and the Forcing group, we are actually really very much involved in many applications for European projects for H2020, and we are running for this flagship initiative. And so being part or being members of Metamorphos actually would imply also so this participation to projects and to be leader in the scientific community also in this sense. Of course, we cannot forget our more institutional activities like the EUPROMETA School, for instance, our European doctoral programs of metamaterials. We have this distributed series of schools. Usually we have three or two or sometimes four events per year. Like this year we had four. And the next edition actually we start tomorrow, and Sergei and this team has organized this one. And then, of course, we have the Congress. So the Congress is actually the most important event we organize as Metamorphose, and actually it allows us to stay alive. So when we collect the registration fees for this Congress, we use part of this also for keeping the association alive, so paying the salary of the involved people. So for us it's actually the only real route for self-sustaining. Sorry. Something went wrong here. Too much? Okay. We are almost close to the end. How about Metamorphose now? We have 26 research institutions belonging to Metamorphose, among universities and research centers, not only from EU, but now we have Andrea, for instance, and this group from the USA. So it's becoming not only European, but ever more global. If you want to join us, you can consider, of course, two options. So the first one, being an institutional member, you are allowed also to participate in these projects we have. Being a personal member, you have the discounts for the participating to our activities, and you are in the communication and contacts we usually give to our members. You can visit the website for more information to have the list, the complete list of the benefits you get being part of Metamorphose. Would like to, if anyone, even not belonging to Metamorphose, would like to organize a next edition of the Congress or of the school, it is not only limited actually to Europe, but it's actually a kind of global call. Please contact us and we will establish the first contacts, and then hopefully this will evolve in a new edition of the Congress or the school. We always like to improve, so please send always your feedback and suggestions about this Congress edition and the school to us. For this particular edition, the local organizers have established this link, so you can go there. You can see the link also on the webpage of our Congress, so you can go there and send your feedback. Now, so let's see what's next. Next edition of the Metamaterials Congress will be back in Rome after the first edition that was back in 2007. And it's going to be held from 16th to 21st of September 2019. You should have received already the first announcement. The dates are fixed, the place has been set as well. We have the submission deadline already fixed, and the Congress website will be launched soon. The general chair of this edition of the Congress in Rome will be Alessio Monti, and the program committee chair will be Martin Wegner. So, before concluding, I would like to ask Alessio to come on the stage and show the presentation he has prepared about the next edition in Rome.
Thank you very much, Filiberto, for the introduction, and good evening, everyone. I'm very glad to introduce, to give you some preliminary information about the next edition of the conference that we are very happy and glad to host in Rome from 16 to 21 September 2019. Okay, just some very basic information about the location of the conference. So you know that Rome is a city is located in the central southwest part of Italy, and it is served by two international airports that you can use to reach the city. Basically, one of these is the Leonardo da Vinci International Airport. It's one of the biggest airports in Europe and has many direct flights from all the European cities and many cities worldwide. There is also another airport you can use that is important hub for many low-cost companies, airlines, especially from Europe. Basically, there are direct flights from all major cities in Europe and many other cities. And from Europe, all the low-cost airlines have flight from and to Rome, so it should be easily reach the venue. Okay, just very few words about the touristic attraction of the city. You know that Rome is known also as the Eternal City because it has been founded the 70 centuries before Christ, and that is has been continuously occupied since then. So basically, you can find a very nice, fascinating stratification of different art cultures. And so maybe it works. I would like to show you a brief, a very short video, okay, about the city that those has never been there. Maybe I just lower the. So, okay, we can now move on with some preliminary information about the event of the Congress. Particularly, it will be take place at the Crown Plaza St. Peter's Hotel. It is located close to the center, in a quiet area close to the city center. Actually, the hotel is at a walking distance by a metro station that you can use to reach the city center in 10 minutes. And the hotel is also sort of offers to its guests a shuttle service from the Fiumicino Airport International at reduced fee you can exploit to reach easier the hotel. Some image of the meeting center we will use. Basically, this is a ground floor with a big plenary room able to hosting up to 600 people for plenary sessions, and that can be divided for hosting plenary sessions. The foyer is placed right in front of the room for poster presentations, exhibitor, sponsor, and coffee break. We have also additional room at the first floor where it's also located the restaurants that will where the lunches will be served, combining international local Italian specialties. So the hotel has also facilities for relaxing during your stay in Rome, such as some outdoor swimming pool, indoor swimming pool, fitness center and spa services. And actually, there will be, of course, discounted rate for the conference delegate that will be available. This is the local staff, actually, in addition to myself and Mirko Barbuto, that we stay at Niccolò Cusano University, Filiberto Bilotti and Alessandro Toscano, full professor at Roma Tre University, and Angelica Marini and Stefano Vellucci, PhD students at Roma Tre University, and Davide Ramaccia is assistant professor at Roma Tre University. Actually, these are two universities of Rome that are co-organizing local institutions. The Roma Tre University has been founded in 1992 as the second biggest university in Rome. It has more than 30 students. 5,000 of them are engineering students, and actually the engineering department is has a more than 150 permanent staff, academic, and 80 PhD students. Niccolò Cusano University is a younger private university in Rome, founded in 2006. The engineering department has been founded in 2013, and it's a growing university with 30 permanent staff, academic permanent staff, and 20 PhD students, the engineering department. Okay, as already Gilberto mentioned, the TPC chair of the next edition of the Congress is Martin Begler from the Cassero Institute of Technology. The deadline has been fixed to the 10th of March 2019. The Congress website is the conventional one, 2019, of course, is already, will be open very soon. And for any information you please feel free to contact us at the institutional address of Metamorphosis. Okay, maybe that's all, and we are welcoming you in Rome next year. Thank you very much.
Okay, so many thanks to all of you also for being here and having attended this edition of the Congress. For Andrea and myself, is the last year we are, according to the regulation of Metamorphos, are the general co-chairs of this Congress, but as actually happened also for Sergei and Alex previously, we will be very much involved in the future organization of the Congress, so we will still hear and very actively support all the activities. And of course, there will be always Metamorphos as the association behind this Congress, owning this Congress. And to me, this is very important because this is not the Congress by a single person, but it's a Congress owned by an entire society with a democratic process of election and so on. So, this was just my last statement, and so thank you all, thank you to the local organizers, and see you next year in Rome.